In this video, we'll cover policies used to correct disequilibrium in the balance of payments. In particular, we'll look at expenditure dampening policies and how they can be used to reduce a current account deficit. Expenditure dampening or reduction policies are policies seeking to reduce a level of spending within an economy. Dampening not only tries to reduce spending levels, but also aims to reduce spending on imports. This should incentivize domestic producers to export more as they find their local markets dampened. If the fall in spending reduces the sales they can earn domestically, they will be encouraged to look abroad for more lucrative markets. To dampen spending, government can increase taxation on individuals to decrease their spending. Increased income tax will result in less disposable income and a fall in consumption spending. Government can also reduce spending on goods and services, which will reduce the government spending component of aggregate demand. Increasing income tax is a difficult policy to pursue, and countries do not frequently change personal income tax systems. By increasing the income tax and reducing consumption, the resulting fall in aggregate demand may increase unemployment. So this is also an issue with the reduction of government spending. Another problem would be considering whether the magnitude of the change is significant enough to achieve the dampening goals intended. Determining the correct levels of change presents a challenge in and of itself. With monetary policy, central banks can increase interest rates to increase the cost of borrowing and raise the reward for savings. This should reduce consumption and investment spending. Central banks can also reduce the money supply, which will ultimately lead to a rise in the interest rate. The effectiveness of these policies will be limited by the response of the economy to changes in interest rates. If the magnitude of the change is not sufficient enough to have the intended impact, the policy may prove to be less effective than initially expected. Contractionary monetary policy can also give rise to higher levels of unemployment. Whether this is an acceptable trade-off will depend on the objectives of the government at the time. The aim of supply-side policies will be to make domestic firms more competitive in export markets. There are many policies that can increase export competitiveness. The ultimate aim will be to increase worker productivity and reduce costs for businesses in export industries. To improve worker productivity, the government can invest in education and skill building and spend money on research and technology. To reduce business costs, they could deregulate export industries, reduce trade union power in those same industries, develop infrastructure, and potentially subsidize exporting firms. For the most part, these policies are more effective in the long term. Also, for them to be truly effective, firms have to take action to capitalize on the reform. Export subsidies are more likely to have an immediate effect, while the other changes may take longer to bear fruit. That's us done with this video on expenditure dampening policies. We're almost done with the course, and I hope you've been finding these videos helpful. Leave your questions or comments below, email me at enhancedtuition@gmail.com, or visit me on my website in the video notes below, and I will see you in the next one.